Dark Souls is a game that's easy. I don't know what you're all talking about. It's not hard, and I'll prove it. Today, I'm going to beat Dark Souls as a pure pyromancer. Just like any other run, we pick pyromancer in the master key. I decide to name her Pyro because I'm original, and we're off. The rules are pretty simple. Kill everything with pyromancies. That's it. It's basically a normal run. I mean, it's not like there's anything immune to fire damage, right? Right? Slap the asylum demon with only 6 fireballs. That's one boss down, 25 to go. This is gonna be easy. In Firelink, we try to put together a plan. If you haven't noticed, we only have 8 total casts of fireball, and that's not a lot. So our first order of business is to get more pyromancies, or a stronger flame, or both. Both is good. The issue is that all three pyromancy teachers are locked behind bosses. Laurentius behind the Capper Demon, Igni behind Quelaag, and Quelana behind a +10 flame. I'm not really ready to take on either of those bosses yet, so let's start prepping. The first thing I do is grab the residence key from the undead merchant, then we do Old Faithful, Undead Berk Skip. I forgot I don't have the key for this door. Well, never let it be said I'm a coward. We free Griggs of Enheim, but you can't guess why. Then we open the shortcut back to Firelink for later. Down through New Londo and into the Valley of Drakes, we grab the Grasscrest Shield and the Red Tearstone Ring. I learned my lesson from last time. We gotta roll. Now we head towards the Swampland to pick up Power Within and Poison Mist. And that's it for setup. There are 20 pyromancies in this game, but only Fireball, Power Within, and Poison Mist are accessible without killing at least one boss. RTSR and Power Within will buff our damage, but only having 8 casts really limits us. We need to reach one of the pyromancy teachers, and for that, we have to take the fight to the Capper Demon. So, there's a perfect fight, where while in RTSR, 6 fireballs is enough to kill the Capper Demon, and that leaves 1 for each of the dogs. I wanted to try out this strategy, but I didn't like the idea that one mistake would cost the fight. From a little testing outside of the boss arena, I found the dogs could be poisoned with one cast of Poison Mist, essentially allowing me a little room to make a couple mistakes. So that's the plan. Poison the dogs, survive until they don't, then pelt the Capper Demon with fireballs. Or so I thought. Do you know what else I learned from a little bit of testing? The Capper Demon can also be poisoned. It's slow, but you know what they say, play lame win games. After about 5 minutes, the poison wears off, and 3 Power Within boosted fireballs later, he's dead and we have access to Laurentius. Now, the run can really start to snowball. Or fireball. Hey, get out of here, you might hurt my new friend! Back at Firelink, we buy Combustion and another set of Fireball, then level up our plane to +4. With Combustion and 2 copies of Fireball, we now have a whopping 32 attacks before resting. Much, much more comfortable. We head towards the Taurus Demon. I'm not a speedrunner, okay? With this many casts, the big bull boy is no problem. He goes down first try. I grab the soapstone from Solaire, something tells me I'm gonna need him later, then listen to the cries of my fellow hollows get torched alive. Or unalive. I use their so graciously donated souls to level up attunement so I can have Power Within equipped. Next, we head towards the gargoyles. Let me tell you, this right here is satisfying. The gargoyles might also be able to be poisoned, but I couldn't tell you because combustion absolutely wrecks them. Back at Firelink, we confront Lautrec and he... That counts as a pyromancy death. I head over to Darkroot Basin to murder a butterfly. Not much else to say, I've played Pokemon, Fire beats Bug type. At this point, there really isn't much to do aside from kill bosses and level up, so it's off to the depths to fight the Open Heart Surgery Dragon. Oh god, I forgot about the Chandler. It's fine, I just gotta be careful. Oh yeah, Power Within. I forgot about that too. Okay, we took care of the Chandler, so this boss isn't... We put the dragon down, first try, don't question it. We up our pyromancy flame to a +10, then go pay Quelana a visit to buy Great Combustion and an extra copy of regular combustion. At this point, we're starting to pack some serious firepower. Pun intended. So let's buff it even more. Over to Darkroot Basin, play around with the blue golems a bit, then murder a Hydra. The Dusk Crown Ring might be useful, but the real prize here is the Crown of Dusk for additional damage. Next, it's off to the Asylum to murder Thick Boy 2.0. We have more than enough cast to handle him, and he goes down first... First try. Don't question it. We grab the doll and the ring before heading back to Firelink, making our way down to Blighttown, where it's finally time to take on Quelaag. This is where we hit a bit of a wall. I'm sure you all knew this, but Quelaag is completely immune to fire damage, so no matter how many combustions we throw at her, they don't work. To make it worse, she also can't be poisoned. So, is that it then? Is the sexy spider lady the pure pyro run killer? I mean, there's no way we can hurt her, right? Wrong. What if I told you that there was a pyromancy that can hurt her? Don't believe me? Two words. Black Flame. Black Flame is a pyromancy that does split physical and fire damage. Quelaag might be immune to fire damage, but she's not immune to blunt force trauma. The problem is that Black Flame is in the Artorias of the Abyss DLC, and you need to pick up an item from the Duke's archives to access it. And to do that, you have to go through Sin's Fortress. And to do that, you have to ring both Bells of Awakening, one of which is behind Quelaag. Do you see the issue here? To hurt Quelaag, we need to have already killed Quelaag. So, is there a way to get there without killing her? There sure is. Sin Skip. I won't go in depth about how to do Sin Skip because I did so in a previous video, and definitely not because my computer crashed and corrupted the recording of me doing it, but basically you confuse the game into thinking you're Schrodinger's undead, both alive and not at the same time. It allows you to pass through the closed gates of Sin's Fortress, effectively skipping the two Bells of Awakening. Anyway, up the bounce house, and once again, Pokemon taught me that fire beats steel. Six fire blasts later, and he's down. Next up, Anorlondo. First thing I do is level up Attunement and Vitality just to stack more casts. Solaire, old friend, glad to see you're doing well. You just rest right there. Let old Pyra take care of the big bad scary men. In a normal playthrough, Orantine and Smough aren't that hard, and this is a mostly normal playthrough. So after a few attempts, the Dream Team goes down first try. We get the giant cups, I mean Lord Vessel, from the illusionary Booba Lady, then we make our way over to the Duke's archives and... What? Oh, that's right. I actually have to place the Lord Vessel. Okay, back to Firelink to talk to... Frampt? Frampt, where are you? This isn't funny, Frampt. Oh, no. The only thing that can awaken the primordial serpent is the sound of the bells. Of awakening. And without placing the Lord Vessel, we can't get to the archives. Is that it then? Does that mean the sexy spider lady really is the run killer?
No, there's another.
Mysterious traveling Havelman!
The only gross snake thing Frampt is not.
Where can I find another gross snake thing?
Darkness you must seek.
Darkness? Thank you, mysterious traveling Havelman. I know what I must do.
Good.
What?
What?
Mysterious traveling Havelman is right. Frampt isn't the only gross snake thing. We have to seek darkness. We need to find Dark Stalker Cath. To plunge ourselves into the abyss, we need to get the Covenant of Artorias. Sorry, Andre, I'm a bit short on souls. You know how it is. The Danger Doggo is no match for us.
I'm not crying, you're crying.
Having committed the second worst sin, we head back to Blighttown for a quick pit stop to make our Enhanced Flame a +1, then it's off to Nulando. Yep, still hate this place. Grab the key, open the gate, then plunge into the darkness. The four kings are an absolute joke at this point. With a weakness to fire and power within on our side, we burn them down like they're nothing. And here he is, the other gross snake thing. Cath, take me to... Wait, what are you doing?
Oh no, don't know what kind of snakes in here. I can't even stand it. I can't throw one noodle. What's this?
God, bro, you ever heard of a tic-tac? Whatever. We place the Lord Vessel, and like that, we've gained access to the Duke's archives. Quelaag, I'm coming for that booty. Ooh, wait, no, I mean we head straight to the archives, make some pork chops, grab the broken pendant, and then die to Seath. Yes, all according to plan. We torch the Lizard Man and bust out of jail. Ladies?
It's okay. I'm into it.
Whoever it from thought invisible walkways over an instant death pit was a good idea? Apparently got a raise because they did the same thing later, but I still hate it. Next, we take on Seath in the revenge match of the century. A weakness to fire isn't doing you any favors here, bud, is it? That's two down, two to go. We head back to Blighttown to make our flame a +4, then it's off to the catacombs. There's that gravity typing again, needs a nerf. Normally, I'd just do one of the skips to get down to Pinwheel faster, but there's actually a couple things we need here. The Darkmoon Seance Ring and a Skull Lantern. With just a hop, drop, and two fire blasts later, Pinwheel is dead. The skull lantern isn't for this place, but it's nice to be able to see— Oh god, what is that? Well, this is off to a great start. Might as well just go for gold and... I am honestly surprised I lived that. Oh well, only one lord left, but I'm not ready for that yet, so let's tie up some loose ends first. We bring our flame to its final form, and who better to test our new power on than everyone's favorite snake boy, Gwendolyn. Yeah, he's not an issue. Since I'm here, I might as well make the internet hate me again. It's off to the painted world. Like normal, we jump the fence, re-dead the undead dragon, and touch the... Oh wait, we can't jump attack the butt. I could just go all the way around, but... Wait, let me check. Okay, the rules say things only have to die to pyromancies, so... We barehand the butt, then meet the true queen, Priscilla. Do I really have to kill her? I mean, she deserves to live. What's that? The fine print of my contract. No, I know it says all bosses, but just this one time. No? Okay. Sorry, internet. I don't like this any more than you do, but Priscilla goes down after the world's saddest game of hide and seek. We actually still haven't grabbed the only pyromancy that can hurt Spider Bay, so it's off to the DLC. First up is the Sanctuary Guardian. Ha, got your tail. A couple more blasts and we make crispy chicken wings out of the Guardian first try. But now is a real challenge. Or so I thought. I don't know, it might be because I have a bajillion points in health, but Artorias really has lost some of his luster recently. He goes down first try. We take a quick jog through the township to pick up the silver pendant, and then we... Okay, who put that gap there? We grab the crest key, then we head towards... We slowly clear out all the enemies, then head towards the Chasm of the Abyss. Here it is, Black Flame, the key to beating the boss that should have died hours ago. I head back so I can equip it, but while I'm here, I might as well take on Manus and Calamite. I could use a few more levels of vitality, don't you think? Manus is no pushover, and the fact that Black Flame knocks him out of his animation is awful. Aw man, can't dodge you that. Wait. Hey Manus. I didn't hear no bell. First try, baby. Now let's go murder a dragon. Calamite proved to be a tiny bit more difficult, but after just 7 attempts, we once again stand above the dragon on the food chain. Now, there's nowhere else to run. It's time to face Quelaag. To be honest, I was a bit nervous about this, but I've come this far, so no turning back now. I proc RTSR and... Yes! I hurt her! But that's not a lot of damage. Even with Power Within on, we only do 253 damage in one cast. Quelaag has 3,139 health points. At 253 damage a cast, we would need to hit her with 13 casts to kill her. Even if we equip the Dust Crown Ring, that would only give us 12 casts. Not to mention that would take a ring slot, so it wouldn't be helpful anyway. So, that's it then. Quelaag is just too tanky for us to kill her with pyromancies alone. But whoever said we had to do it alone? I always do these challenges solo, but I never actually made it a rule that I can't summon. No, the only rule is that enemies have to die to my pyromancies. That's right, it's time to enlist the help of everyone's favorite sack-wearing, butcher knife-wielding psycho, Maneater Mildred. Mildred, what are you... That's not even the arena, how did you get in there? Oh shit, wait, she can still hit Quelaag. Okay, this could work. Who says Dark Souls isn't janky? So Mildred definitely leveled up her fire resistance, but at the cost of her intelligence. She's pretty stupid. If she's not standing in lava, she's doing whatever this is. After a couple more tries, Mildred did just enough damage that we were able to finish off Quelaag with only our pyromancies. Thanks, Mildred. You will not be remembered. Next up is Ceaseless, and even though he's immune to fire damage, he's not immune to cheese. You all saw this coming. Doesn't this technically mean he died to gravity? We make our way to the Demon Fire Sage, who is not immune to fire damage. I don't know why, and I don't really care why, but he's not, and he's dead. Of the four bosses that are immune to fire damage, I was only worried about two of them, Quelaag and the Centipede Demon. It's unfortunate, but the Centipede Demon will have to fall the same way Quelaag did, with a little help from Solaire? Buddy? I could use some of that jolly cooperation right about now. Buddy? Oh no. Yeah, so for whatever reason, Solaire isn't here to help us. We're gonna have to fight the demon alone. Okay, we can hurt him with Black Flame, that's good. Let's just blow his arm off, get the ring, then try to think of a plan. Okay, I'll level with you. Without Solaire, I'm not sure how to do this. Originally, I was just gonna have him come in and beat the boss down, but we finish it, but now, I don't know. Even with Power Within and RTSR on, there is no way we're gonna be able to do enough damage to kill him. I mean, the Centipede Demon has more health and defenses than Quelaag, so I don't know. I don't know what to do. I think the run might be over. Wait. Do you see what I see? The Centipede Demon can be poisoned. Well, I think. This is my desperate logic, but Quelaag had an S resistance and poison, but the Centipede Demon only has an A, same as Capra, therefore can be poisoned. I hope. Well, it's worth a shot. Oh baby, we're in business. Okay, it's slow, but he's dying. The problem now is that 4 casts of Poison Mist is not enough to lower his HP to within Black Flame kill range. However, there is another copy of Poison Mist we can get. Igni. He only sells to us if we're infested with eggs, but that's not really a problem, so we get knockoff face hugged, and after a few minutes we turn into this, then by Poison Mist. Igni, you might have saved this run. I could kiss you, but I'm not going to because you're a gross egg thing. Okay, so after some playing around, I found out in order to make this work, you need the Dust Crown, Bellowing Dragon Crest Ring, and Power Within. Then you need to hit all 8 casts of Black Flame and proc poison 4 times. It takes 2 Poison Mist to proc, and you have 9 total. This means you need a near perfect run in order to kill him. I say nearly perfect because you can miss one cast of Poison Mist and still be okay, and if you use RTSR you'll get more damage, but since each run took 20-ish minutes, I didn't want to be in one-shot range. Before you ask, I did try to use Toxic Mist, but with only one cast is just not enough. I thought about using Dung Pies to stack it, but didn't think throwing literal shit at the boss was very Pyromancer. Anyway, several heartbreaking attempts later, I did it. The Centipede Demon dies to only Pyromancies, and we didn't even need... If it weren't for the law of this land, I would kill you. Next is the Bed of Chaos. Surprisingly, I did this without an issue. The Bed is also immune to fire damage, but he has literally 2 health, so it's not a problem. Having not forgotten any bosses this time, we head back to Firelink to... Oh, now you're here? Whatever, we descend into the kiln and make our way to Gwyn. A parry and 6 black flames later, and we've done it. We have beaten Dark Souls as a pure Pyromancer. Hey everyone, thank you so much for watching. If you liked what you saw, please consider giving a like and subscribing, it really helps me out. And a huge thanks to my friend Traveler for providing the voice of Mysterious Traveling Havelman. I told him to do a Yoda voice, I don't really know why, but let's rate how he was out of 10 in the comments below. I give him a solid... like 6, maybe 7? This run was a lot of fun. I really thought Quelaag was going to die with an 8 cast, but then she kind of just didn't. I'm disappointed that I had to summon Mildred for the fight, but actually really proud of how I ended up killing the Centipede Demon. I had no idea that's how that fight would go, and I was legitimately panicking when Solaire summon sign didn't show up. Anyway, I've seen your suggestions, shield run only, consumables only, I'm going to do those as well. Sorry that they haven't come out yet. As you can imagine, that kind of run takes a little bit more time. But don't worry, I've started playing them out, so soon, TM. Anyway, everyone, thanks again for watching, and I will see you next time.